In this illustration, we'll analyze a disk rotating about a chord. We are given that a uniform circular disk has radius r and mass m. A particle also mass m is fixed at point A on the edge of the disk as shown in figure. The disk can freely rotate about a fixed horizontal axis pq, which is along a chord of disk at a distance r by 4 from the center. Initially, a disk is held in vertical plane with A at the highest point, and now it is allowed to fall from rest. We are required to find the linear speed of the particle as it reaches the lowest position. Now, in this situation here, we can write, when the disk reaches the lowest position, it will rotate by 180 degree with respect to the axis PQ, and this would be the final position of the disk when it is inverted. Point C, the center of mass of rod, will drop down by a total distance r by 2, and finally it is at r by 4 below the chord PQ. So, in this situation, this mass which is fixed at point A will also fall down by a distance twice of r plus r by 4, as now it is at a distance r plus r by 4 below the chord PQ, as about this chord it is rotating. So, here we can say from initial to final position of this, we use work energy theorem as, here we can see initial kinetic energy of the disk was 0 plus the work done by gravity on the disk will be as center mass of disk falls by a distance r by 2. So, we can write it as mg multiplied by r by 2 plus work done by gravity on this particle which has fallen by a distance twice of r plus r by 4, that is 5 r by 2, will be mgh, and that is 5 r by 2. This must be equals to the final kinetic energy of this system which is rotating about the chord PQ. Then its total moment of inertia, first we calculate, and we use energy as half I omega square. So, half moment of inertia of the system we can write as, for this point mass as it is at a distance 5 r by 4, its moment of inertia we can write as m 5 r by 4 whole square plus the moment of inertia of disk about the central diametrical axis is 1 by 4 m r square plus we use the parallel axis theorem, we use m d square, this m multiplied by r by 4 whole square multiplied by omega square. So, this is the moment of inertia of the system where this can be considered as mi of point mass, and this section is the moment of inertia of the disk about axis of rotation PQ, which we have calculated by using parallel axis theorem. Now, simplifying this relation, here we can see m gets cancelled out, and this gives us 3gr is equals to r, we can take common out, so this is half r square multiplied by this 25 by 16 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 16 multiplied by omega square. So, this numerical value gives us 3gr is equals to 30 by 32 r square omega square. So, here one r gets cancelled out, and in this situation the value of omega we are getting is, this giving us the value of omega as root of 16g by 5r. And as we have got the angular speed omega, we are required to finally find the linear speed of particle as it reaches the lowest position. So, this gives us velocity of particle A. We can write as 5r by 4 times omega, as it is moving in a circle of radius 5r by 4. So, this is 5r by 4 multiplied by root of 16g by 5r, which is finally giving us root of 5gr, that is the result of this problem.